those of you that have been to the other concert of the series, to Baroque Stock and to Eat Street Baptist Church. It's so touching to see so many of you. You can't even imagine, after all this time that we have been, as musicians, most of the time sitting in front of the computer, looking at someone and trying to play together, to teach music. So it's, you know, to see real people and to know that I'm gonna, and we are gonna produce sound for you is incredibly rewarding. Already half of the concert is done for me. Couple of communication as usual for the people that are here, welcome back. For the people that aren't been here other times, please, before you go away, make sure you take one of our little leaflets where you can see the remaining concerts of the series. There is another one on Sunday, 27th at 6 p.m. and another one at the beginning of July. And also you'll find the details to follow our events, to go on our website, to go on our Facebook page, to follow our YouTube channel. It's all things that are very important for us to be connected and to let you know when things are happening here. As someone of you might know, Baroque Stock is a festival. This time we decide to put on a concert series, which was a reopening one for this building, but also for us to go on stage again. So there's a huge thank you to a couple of really dear friends that they helped us with money to be able to be on stage tonight, and to Continuo Foundation, which has sponsored some of the concert on the series. You'll see that some of the concerts are from a band called Boxwood and Brass, which they do historical repertoire for wind instruments. And the other band is the Stati Collective, which you will see on stage tonight, and we have proposed all sorts of different repertoire. Tonight we are starting with something incredibly deep, and that's why we have put this piece at the very beginning. Johann Sebastian Bach cantata BWV 84. I'm not even gonna try to say the title in German, so you'll hear Hilary singing it. And the reason why this piece is together with everything else that you see on the program, it might sound quite far to you, but it's actually dance. And tonight you will experience how dance and movement and the gesture of the dance as a Baroque musician, but also as music that hopefully will just go through all of you in the hall, is the crucial point of the program of tonight. And you will see it in any sort of form. You know that the Bach cantatas were performed during the service. So we are actually during the church service, which I encourage you to come in this church when we actually perform the cantatas during the service, because they're incredibly powerful in the meaning that they have in the world. And tonight's piece, as I said, is also about dance. You will hear the cantata starting with this very slow dance minuet, and then there is a folk dance in the middle. You will hear the oboe and the violin dialogue with the soprano in something that doesn't seem that sacred, but Bach managed to kind of gather everything in the mood of the cantata. And the usual chorale at the end, which in non-COVID time would be very beautiful to sing all together, you know, tonight, just imagine it in your head and sing with us and with Hilary the last piece. And then I will say a few words about the next piece after. So please enjoy the concert and welcome on stage the other members of Istanti Collective. So please feel relaxed, coughing and stretch. Maybe, you know, don't move too much around, but maybe you have now the chance to send a text to your friend and say, please watch the concert, and then you switch off. Right. So please invite people. You have 1 minute more to tune in and then switch the phone. And when you go back home, if you love the concert, you can watch it back for a couple of days more. And again, invite people to share it and to enjoy the music if they can't be here now tonight. Thank you.
Thank you.
change now completely atmosphere, but I still hope that you will catch the connection between what we've just played and the musical planet that we're moving now to. So in terms of historical time, we're not that apart. We're moving to France now, probably on an evening at the court, and there are some musicians that are playing for the king. And that's probably the setting where François Couperin was mostly delivering his music. And especially two long set of collections that are called Concert Royal. So specifically written and dedicated to the king, but an incredible source of information about dance and music in France at the time. And it's true that they didn't have internet or Facebook or all this kind of sort of stuff, so the connection between all these musicians was way slower, but still information, music, and printing of this music were circulating around Europe. So, you know, the main character at the time, they were somehow in contact. So we did choose one of those concertos, actually probably one of my favorite, and those concertos are simply on the paper a set of dances, which they use the usual Baroque dances, saraband, gavotte, rigoudon, sicilienne, but what is special about it is how the composer treats this dance and what kind of, let's say, story tell us in within the little time of the concerto. So this one actually started in a quite proud way. It says gravement, like really walking and sure about himself. And there are already some small images of doubt inside that. We don't really know if he's gonna go in a very funny way or in a very tragic one. The second movement, which is an allemande, tell us that probably there's something quite funny happening. And you will hear the oboe probably imitating an animal, which I leave you to imagine what is it. I think it will be quite clear. But still, on the paper, it is an allemande, so something really, you know, regal and steady and composed. Then we move into probably the sweetest piece of the set, saraband, where really I encourage, if you are in a bubble, to kind of cuddle each other. I think that's what we would love to see from stage. But also at that point, you'll hear that it's not just the dance. You'll hear that the way the movement is treated is quite peculiar. You'll hear, for example, the bass line, the bass department there, like going with a really sweet and touchy rhythm behind this very sustained and easy melody on top. And then, you know, the excitement arrived. There's the air du diable. So we don't know what he's talking about in this sense, because those concertos were quite small, and so the emotion is either very big or very small, so there's no time to much develop. But this air du diable is a moment of tempest. In a second is kind of clear up, away, everything is being said. And then the kind of theatrical genius of Couperin, even though he didn't write probably a single line for the theatre, is to put at the end another slow movement, really a lullaby. So if you haven't cuddled on the third one, that's your last chance to do it in the last one. And this will be a kind of really soft ending of the first half, so you will get ready to move, stand up and go outside and have a glass of wine from the little Baroque Soft Bakery bar that will appear on the side. And then there's going to be freshly baked focaccia and some wine, and we also have to refresh the air, so I encourage everyone slowly to have a little bit of chat outside, and then we'll start the second half. Hope you will enjoy this, moving straight away to France, and then we will be back with something that mixed the two together. Thank you very much.
Oh.
Welcome back, everyone. Hope you're not too drunk, or you know. But I think this will create the atmosphere for where we're going now. So we have heard some fairly serious but really touching, I think, Bach and German music. We've heard some probably more uplifted but also extremely emotional Couperin. And now we try to mix the two with another friend of ours, which is Georg Philipp Telemann. At the time, you might know something about him, but let me just say a few words about this guy. At the time, he's a contemporary of Bach, so they kind of lived at the same time. And at the time, he was way more famous than Bach, which wasn't as famous as he is now. So Telemann was really the big name. So he got all the jobs that Bach then took over after, and he wrote an incredible amount of music. And what is nice about Telemann is that he really wrote something for any sort of instrument and any sort of combination. So as a concert organizer, we quite like him because you always find something to put in a program, despite the combination of instruments on stage. And it's always very good quality music, because he was also a very successful seller of his own music. And there is so much of his music that hasn't been really published or performed much, as the suite overture you're gonna hear now. I have to thank you, Richard, which I don't think he's here, then is a dear flute player friend, which actually transcribed the entire music you're gonna hear now from the manuscript into modern edition, because there wasn't a modern edition. So without him, it wasn't really possible to make it happen so quickly. So thank you, Richard, if you're watching us from Facebook or YouTube. As I said, Telemann, in this case, is trying to melt together the German style and the French style. I'm sure you have noticed how different in the speaking this music is from Bach to Couperin. And now you will hear how Telemann is trying to mix the two. Sometimes it does quite well. Some other times it doesn't really work that perfect, but it's very sweet and actually it's so nice to see the effort and to see what is the output, something completely different. So this overture kind of works in the same manner as the concerto you've just heard. So it's a series of dances, again in the French style. So we're gonna start with an overture, an actual overture, that has a slow beat and a fast one in the middle. Then we go in a list of smaller dances, an entree, then a rigodon, and the more we go into the story of this overture, and the more you will see small solos, so small instruments popping up and doing something alone. And then we move again. If you haven't done it yet, now is the moment after the wine, the cuddling moment. So there is an air again. Well, please, that's the moment where you can relax and just enjoy whoever you have next to you or whoever you have in mind. And then we go into the folk music, really folk music. Telemann was really a fan of using folk melodies, especially from Central Europe and Central Eastern Europe, and just slotting some of these into his compositions. And it's quite nice how he does that, because he doesn't correct this music. So he doesn't put the music in the way that needs to be square into a, let's say, official classical composition. He just takes it as it is, and just has fun with it. So you'll have a polished dance, and then we go back for a second to something really, really organized, a passepied, so again, a French dance, to then go into an arlecchinante. So then you have to imagine some masks from the carnival, from Italian carnival, that are probably chatting to each other. And the music is really telling you how messy and how in love probably is Arlecchino and how not in love is Colombino with him. And then you will see how this jumping of rhythm goes from one side to the other of the stage. And then, again, in a theatrical manner, we end up with a minuet. We have all had a story, we have all laughed, and now we go back to normal and we leave you dancing something that will make you in peace. One extra information on this next piece is the color. I've changed instrument and being the only wind player in this combination today, I took up this very funny one, which is the Oboe d'Amore. This was an instrument invented around the time of Telemann and Bach in Germany, so it wasn't a French instrument at all, and it's very nice that Telemann, to create what probably thought was a French sound, use this tenor version of the oboe, so it's just slightly longer with this funny bow at the end, and have this quite covered and sweet sound, and that's probably help the band to have this different color, which I hope you'll enjoy. So welcome again on stage, my friends from Istanti Collective, and see you before the next piece. So far it's been kind of a story, no? I think we've gone from, again, from Germany to France and then together. And the last piece doesn't really have a reason to be in the program, but it's just about us. And we are also part of this garden stage. So I thought it was brilliant, the idea that Hilary gave us. We were chatting and saying, okay, would be nice to finish the concert all together. So you've sung the cantata. Is there something we can do at the end? And we did speculate a bit. We can do a Christmas oratorio aria and stuff. And then she said, well, why don't we do a Mozart aria? And I was like, yes, perfect. It might not fit with the Telemann, but it fit with, the atmosphere here, which has to be relaxed when you sit down and enjoy the music and have time to think through anything you need to think through while you're listening. So this last aria is quite interesting because it's at the end. So we are in Così fan tutte, one of the main operas of Mozart, the last one he produced with an Italian guy called Da Ponte, which was writing for him the libretto. And it's a sort of comic opera, and in the manner of the time, there are a serious character, like quite proud of himself, and then a bit of a comic one. And then there are characters that they go in between according to what the story, which is almost all the time about love and who is, you know, is going to get together with who and who he can't get together with that person. And in this case, we have in Fior di Ligi ending our concert tonight, and which is just quite proud. And she states that, yes, whatever is going to happen, I'm going to be faithful and absolutely going through my ideas, as we probably have done through this lockdown and those times, like really faithful to the fact that we are still on stage doing our job. And it's very important you're sitting there, because if you're not sitting there, there's very little reason for us to be on stage by ourselves. So please come back next time. And the next one is on Saturday, and we have already introduced the theme of the next concert, which is folk and the connection between Baroque and folk, and we will have also connection with the songs, folk songs, which are part of the historical performance, but they are always been part of the tradition of this country, like Dolan, Parcel, and going through till Britain. And so please come, because it's a quite experimental program on Sunday, as we like to do here. And that's also the reason why, at the end of a Baroque concert, you'll get a Mozart aria, which I think is great. Also, if you want to help us and support us in any sort of way, if you have a bit of money spare, I know everyone is quite poor at the time, but you know, we do rely on the fact that you help us. Come and talk to me, to Gionelli, which is the guy sitting at all the machinery there, which make happens everything and anything about technology here. And also he brings the flyer, and the other person with me organizing all of this. And then please have a look at this space and come back to see anything else going on here. There is an awful lot of stuff, of beautiful stuff going here. You can come as soon as we're allowed to sing in a choir. You can come to the service where you often get music and sometimes also the cantatas. So, you know, without this space, again, this wouldn't be possible. So please come back in any sort of way, talk to us, and one last stuff. When you go out, you might want a CD, you know? You might want a CD of us playing to bring back home, and this will be another way to support us. So please have a look, and then stay to chat with us outside, not inside, outside. And we hope that you enjoy this evening, and please welcome back again Hilary Cronin. So I can try to remember, and I'm sure I get it wrong, even though they are my best friends. Simone and Sarah at violins, Kate on the cello, Sean at the harpsichord, Emma on viola, Josie on the double bass, and Johan, which is sitting there, but you know, without him, the folk stuff wouldn't be possible. Please go on the website and check the names and find out about everyone else. I'm so sorry. It's